Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back. Today I'm going to create a spring birthday card using these new products by Nuvo. These are watercolor pencils and they come in a set of two. And they are not available in the market yet in the US, but they will be soon. However, they are available in the UK. And the stamp set that I will be working with is Window Messages by Stampendous. This is a clear stamp set that gives you four different designs of flowers with lovely words such as happy, enjoy, smile, and thank you. I am going to work with the happy one. I'm going to stamp it on a square piece of watercolor paper, and I'm going to use archival ink just because it's going to be permanent when it dries. I will be working with watercolor pencils and water, so I need to make sure that this is not going to smudge. Now, on every watercolor paper, there are two sides. One is quite textured and the other one is more smooth. I always like to see that texture on the paper, and that's why I'm working on the textured side today. But I need to stamp a couple of times, one on top of the other, just to make sure that I get a nice and crisp image. And that's why I'm using my stamping platform by Tim Holtz. By the way, the watercolor paper that I'm working on today is by Nuvo. It's a new product and I just wanted to see how it works with watercolor pencils. There are different ways to apply color with your watercolor pencils. One way is to apply color on your paper directly when it's dry and just move the color and blend it out with a water brush. Another way is to pick up a pencil and get the color from the nib, just like I'm doing here with the blue one. This way you have more control on how much paint you apply. And finally, you can create your own palette and just pick up the color from there. And there are more ways to apply the color with these pencils. For example, you can wet the paper first and then go directly with the pencils on your paper. This is going to give you more vibrant colors. But these are the three ways that I will be working with today. I will only use pencils from the first set. This is called Brilliantly Vibrant. And as you can see, it gives you 12 different colors in a lovely tin. And the second set is perfect for hair and skin tones. So as you can see, I'm applying my blue and my green. I did apply a little bit of blue at the top and now the green at the bottom. I'm not pressing too hard. I want to apply just a touch of color on my paper. I can always add more if I want to and make it look more vibrant. But if I add too much from the beginning, then it will be difficult for me to blend it out as well as to lift it if I need to. So I'm first applying a very light color, blending it out with my water brush. By the way, the water brush that I'm using is also by Nuvo, by Tonic Studios. And once I have blended out my blue area, then I will start from the bottom and start blending the green towards the top. And to make it look more interesting, I'm also going to add some yellow. And as you can see, I'm using my other scrap piece of paper as a palette, just to pick up a little bit of yellow and mix it in with my green one. Once the first layer is dry, I will go ahead and add more vibrant color on top of it, just to intensify some of the areas. I'm picking up the color directly from the nib and applying it on my paper. And if you use this technique with your watercolor pencils, you will find out that they will last you for a lifetime because you will not need to sharpen them as often. And again, with the same technique, I am adding some yellow at the bottom for my ground. And as I go towards the top, I'm trying to mix both colors. I will go with a darker green now. And all the colors have a very creative name, as usual with craft supplies. So this is Imperial Jade. The yellow I used is called Spring Daffodil. And the blue one was Scuba Blue. Now, making sure that the background is dry before I go ahead and start working on my flower. And I do promise when these pencils become widely available, I will make a product review video where you will see a swatch of all the colors, how you can mix and match them, the pros and cons and everything else. And if you have any questions about these pencils, make sure to leave a comment below and I will be sure to address them in the video review. Now I'm going to use the red one to color the petals of my flower. Now for the last 3 days there has been a great sale on stamps, both rubber and clear ones, and today is the last day, so if you want to check it out, make sure to visit the link down below and go to my blog to find all about it. Every stamp is on sale, including the one that I'm using today. Notice that I did the same technique on the petals as well. So first I applied a very light layer of color, and this is going to provide me areas of highlights. And now with the other technique, where I pick up color directly from the nib, I add the shading. So by using just one pencil, I get my highlights and my shadows. I usually cut off parts of my coloring, just because I think that they make my video really long, and maybe it is boring for some people. But today I decided to just leave the whole process so you can see how I did it. I'm also going to stamp this flower a second time and color it again using the same techniques, so that I can cut it out and pop it on top of this card. This is going to give me some dimension. So while I'm coloring the center of the flower, I can chat a little bit and let you know where I have been for the last week. So I have been traveling with family and friends for a week in Amsterdam. We had a lovely vacation. The weather was perfect. It was mostly sunny, which gave us a chance to visit pretty much everything. It was a really inspiring trip, because I got the chance, in between doing so many different things, to visit museums. They have amazing collections there. I went to the Van Gogh Museum, where I got to see original paintings such as his sunflowers and the cherry blossoms, real masterpieces, which I absolutely adore. All in all, it was an amazing holiday. So anyway, back to the card now. As you can see, I'm using a black marker. I'm going all around the outside edge just to get rid of that white edge. And this is going to make my flower look as if it was cut perfectly. And then I can stick it on top of the other flower with a foam square at the back. And the fact that I have colored both flowers, the one underneath as well as the one on top, gives the illusion that this flower is more fluffy, and when you lift the card you can see the other one underneath. Now you can leave this as it is and stick it on a square card base, and you have a card ready to go. I'm going to show you how you can take it a step further. So I'm going to stick this piece of pattern paper with black and white stripes. And to embellish it a little bit more, I have this white string, which I'm going to wrap 3 times and then tie a bow. Now this can be a happy birthday card or a happy spring card. It can be anything really, just to say hello. I'm going to turn it into a happy birthday card because I have quite a few birthdays for April. For my card base, I created a square 4x4 card base using green cardstock. And I'm using some foam tape at the back to stick this panel on top. I find that 4x4 cards are the perfect size to put inside the gift that you will hand out. Now for the inside of my card, I'm going to use the word happy from one of those two lovely stamp sets by Stampentus. These stamp sets actually are new and they are on sale. They give you a lovely big font that you can combine with smaller sentiments, so that you can mix and match the sentiments and create your own. And since this is going to be a happy birthday card, I went with the word happy, which I am stamping a couple of times just to make sure that this is nice, vibrant and solid. And underneath I'm going to combine it with the word birthday, which this time I'm stamping with another color of ink, which matches perfectly with the cardstock that I'm using. This white panel is a quarter of an inch smaller than the 4x4 square card, so it fits nicely inside my card, but it leaves a nice border around it. I'm going to add some tape adhesive and stick it on inside. As you can see, I do still have some room to write my message. And because I can keep adding details on a card, I am going to add some dots at the center of my flower with my black Nouveau Drops, just where those black dots are already stamped, which is going to give an extra dimension on my flower. And you can actually go ahead and do those with white if you want to highlight the center even more. So that was the card for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. Don't forget that you will find the full list of all the supplies that I used down below in the description area, as well as on my blog. Here are some close-up photos of the card that I made today. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time.